We've got a very interesting topic today. The problem with vintage Steinways. As a retailer of vintage Steinways, we're going to come clean. This is the issue with vintage Steinways. Stick around for a hot take.
Hi, this is Ted with Alamo Music Center in beautiful downtown San Antonio, Texas.
I'm Patrick Maher. You can find us online at alamomusic.com. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our YouTube channels, check out our other videos, sign up for notifications, like our videos, leave us comments. We appreciate your support and we love to interact with you. Steinway.
Steinway. Vintage Steinway.
It's a word that triggers a lot of people in the piano industry.
It does, and there's tons and tons of articles in the major news, and then in, you know, local news and everything, there's always a piano around the store too, but vintage Steinway pianos.
We should like count up how many articles NPR writes every year on Steinway.
It's got to be 90%.
Or the New York Times. The New York Times.
90% plus of everything they write about piano will include Steinway.
Oh yeah, for sure. And for good reason.
Well, here, you mentioned like the problem with vintage Steinways as opposed to the problem with vintage pianos. Because pianos are different. They're not vintage Steinways.
They're different. It's not only like Steinway isn't a subcategory of piano. It's almost like its own world. And there's very few brands that can do this. And so like first, hats off to Steinway. I think that's what we have to start with.
For the consistency of maintaining their company and staying in business, even through war times and not having their stuff confiscated.
A great story. Steinway is an American brand that really has, you know, taken the piano industry by storm and been the, one of the dominant players for over 100 years. So very, very much hats off to Steinway. And for the most part, a very, very good product.
Well, most people say it's the most recognized brand of piano in the world. And I contend after 20 plus years of selling pianos, I think it's the only brand recognized in the world by the majority of people that come in here. Because they say, aren't Steinways the best? And I would say, as opposed to what? Can you name me some others?
Well, so, not to divulge too much,
no, but there's some truth to that.
Yeah, and so, here we are, the problem with vintage Steinways. And this is...
They age and fall apart and get stiff and things go wrong with it, just like any other piano.
Yeah, but I think where the major issue is the brand itself is worth more than the instrument itself.
Without a doubt.
And so that's kind of the whole thesis of this video is Steinway's brand is a very popular name, very recognized, very sought after, and creates a very great product, new and in the last 100 years has created a great product that people are willing to spend money on and, you know, for the most part, protect their investment on. But like other industries, The most well-known thing is often overvalued in some sense of the word. And so today we're talking about vintage Steinways specifically, and we played one, and it's a
run-of-the-mill vintage Steinway.
It's a vintage Steinway. It's a 1920s model, I want to say L.
And I don't think it's had anything major done to it.
Yeah, and it's, I think, selling for about $10,000. And so, you know, if you do a quick Google search, model L online, that's probably below cost or below average of cost on it, but you know, we are selling it in a pre-rebuilt condition, and we're doing that because of this issue with Steinway and because of the public's perception of what a rebuilt Steinway needs to be and what a rebuilt Steinway or rebuilt piano is. And so again, the major issue is brand perception and public perception of the value of this instrument. And so you'll see a lot of very expensive Steinways that are probably not very great pianos.
Right. I've played one. It cost almost $250,000, and you can only play two notes here and one down here. So you, if you play more than one bass note, it gets so muddy you can't distinguish, and there's no harmonic integrity to it.
Yeah, and so when you look at vintage instruments in general, vintage pianos, there's a whole bunch of things that people go down a list and want to check. You know, they want to check how many years has it been around? You know, when was it made? What's the condition of it? They want to get a technician out to look at you know, the wear and tear on the instrument, has any major repairs been done to it. They also want to basically check to make sure that it was cared for appropriately, that there, you know, wasn't left out in the extreme heat or the extreme cold. And there's all these things that you go down the list. And for the most part, at the end of that conversation, if it's a very vintage kind of antique piano, the conversation is, it's not worth buying this instrument because it would cost more to fix it than it would be to get something else.
Well, then there's, when you're refurbishing, remanufacturing, or reconditioning a piano, the question always comes up, well, do you have to completely redo it? Can you just do some of it? Well, like, what sum would you like? Mm-hmm. Like new strings without new hammers, or just new hammers with the same old rusty strings? You want us to get all the things to work right? I mean, you can't partially do something like that and expect it to not like brand new, but, you know, still better than what it is now.
And
so when you're taking strings and pins and dampers, there's no way you can just partially do that.
Mm-hmm. And so that's why the conversation often comes to the conclusion that this is not worth rebuilding. Right. And that's on vintage pianos. But then you change the conversation and you just replace pianos with Steinway, and the conversation completely changes. It flips on its head.
Well, some people, hey, I know you have, you're proud of your brand new Steinway, but mine's a 100-year-old one, and I had it completely refurbished, which instantly says mine's better than yours because it's older. And then you find out, you ask me enough questions about how I had my piano remanufactured, rebuilt, and I tell you, oh yeah, well, they put a new soundboard in it. Well, it's not a vintage instrument.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a new soundboard in it, you have a vintage frame
with
vintage keys, and you're not going to get vintage sound out of a brand new soundboard. And so most refurbished and remanufactured vintage Steinways that are worth their weight in money and the sound are ones where they kept the original soundboard, usually the Steinway B's. Even if they take it out and rework it and put it back in,
mm-hmm.
there's nothing like aged wood. And that's really what you're after, that aged frame and soundboard. When you replace a soundboard, you're making it like a brand new instrument again.
Yeah, and to that point, there's always a paper trail of rebuilt Steinways. And then if there's ever been work, like, so say we get a vintage Steinway here in the store, and we can tell there's been something done to it. A lot of times we see this, but there's no paper trail. It immediately devalues the instrument.
Somebody's uncle did it in the garage on a weekend.
Oh, it got repainted, you know, it was sanded down, repainted, and the finish has been done, or, oh, we got restrung with something, or new hammers. And immediately, like, oh, you can see the dollar bills just deducting. And it's I would compare it to, you know, classic cars, that watches.
Well, right. Now, how about this? Well, I had my Steinway remanufactured at the Steinway factory. I shipped it to him. I had it come back. It's like, you had Steinway parts put into a Steinway B, or one of their major big D models, which means you have now lesser hammers than what were in there and lesser action, because they come with Renner action and Renner hammers. And so, do you really want Steinway parts when Steinway didn't give you Steinway parts in the first place?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, some of the action that's in their upper grade pianos is better than what they build. So if you send them your vintage Steinway and they put in Steinway action instead of the action that was in it, you have a lesser quality instrument.
And so I think we see this in other industries again, the actual value of a Rolls Royce to what it's perceived as and the worth of it, the actual value of a Rolex watch and what its, you know,
right.
perceived value is. It correlates very well to what Steinway, you know, the value of what a Steinway is, and what, you know, if you got a piece of paper out and said, okay, it's made very similarly to a lot of these other instruments, but it's made in New York with skilled labor who live in New York, and you start adding
union labor
that works in New York, and then you look at what a vintage Steinway sells for, you know, you build up this public perception of and the marketing so great, but it's what is the main issue? It's that the brand is valued over what the instrument's worth, and unless you take very, very precise care of it, you can start going down a rabbit hole and saying, well, you know, we need to replace this, or, you know, it doesn't sound good, because finding the right instrument is a very subjective experience. I think we talked about this.
It is.
You know, you talk about the warmth, the sound, the feel, all these things that are
things that can't scientifically be explained.
Mm-hmm.
How do you put math behind, oh, it's so warm sounding?
And so what Steinway has done is it over, like, just having the name on the fall board, creates this, and it's gotten to a point where Steinway, they had stopped licensing stickers for their names and things like that because they're so afraid of people, you know, counterfeiting their product because of how powerful that name is. And so just an interesting take and kind of what we see as the major issue of vintage Steinway.
The major issue with vintage Steinway is they're no better and no worse than any other piano manufacturer except when it comes to pricing. And I've always said that you can get better pianos than a Steinway. You can get a better watch than a Rolex, and you can get a better car than a Rolls Royce, but you're going to be really hard-pressed to pay more. Mm-hmm. And that's whether it's brand new out of the factory or if someone refurbished and reconditioned it, because certain Rolex models are worth tons of times more than they were just for their gold value, you know? And so there's all of that. Rolex isn't really just a timepiece. It's a statement.
It's what people are willing to pay for.
It's what they're willing to pay for.
And so, and Steinway has this really good marketing pitch that I've heard over the last couple of years, but there's the Steinway and there's the Steinways. And a lot of times when you start putting things into a Steinway that are not Steinway official, if they don't go through the Steinway factory in New York, they will start calling this the Steinways because it used to.
And there's also, you know, Frankensteinways, where you, when you take the piano apart, you take off the fall board, the cheek blocks, and you notice, let me see, this key case has a different serial number than the one that's on the frame and a different one that's on the key bed. So this piano was assembled from two or three. It's a Frankensteinway.
We see those sometimes.
Yeah, we get those sometimes. Not as much as we do in the guitars, because there's so many of those Frankenfenders that are out there. I mean, people have parts and frames.
They put them all together,
Gibson pickups and necks and stuff.
So we know this is a hot topic, and we really would like your insight. If you guys could leave some comments on your thoughts on vintage Steinways. Maybe you've owned one, maybe you've played one. There are a plethora out there, and they range all the way from some of the best sounding playing instruments to some of the worst sounding playing instruments.
At the same time, I played the Steinway that was next to the Beckstein behind the register, and so there's video of that. And what I can say is this is a normal, typical type of vintage piano we get in here. This one happens to be a Steinway. And as a Steinway, it's very typical of what a vintage Steinway is. You're going to pay about, you know, somewhere from $10,000 on up just to get the goods that you know then need to be partially remanufactured or redone.
And it's not
always the soundboard. The soundboard is the one thing that you should really try to maintain the integrity. But pins, strings, and all the felts and hammers, along with an action and voicing, will make a piano really nice. Now, this one here, I struggled with playing, as you can see. I actually, there's a point there where I think one of the key tops almost comes off. And because it was loose, it needs to be re-glued.
Yeah.
But this is a piano that came in, we set it up, and it's there. We haven't done anything to it. I don't even think we tuned it. So there's a lot to be said about the quality of just piano manufacturing in the 1920s, as in that other one, the video from the Beckstein was in 1909. And these are pianos that had very little work, no extreme modifications done to them, but you can at least see how they sound and how they play and how we get them. And sometimes people come in and say, I want this piano, but I want it to be able to play and sound like it's brand new. And that can be achieved for a small price.
Yeah, and that's kind of what we'll leave it on. One of the interesting things about vintage Steinways is you can spend money into it and at the end of the day have something that's more valuable if you do
That's why people are after vintage pianos, because they want to maintain the initial investment with the Steinway & Sons and the quality of the instrument. And so a lot of times bringing the quality of the instrument returns value, whether it's a Steinway or any other piano. But Steinways, it seems to return more value because you pay more for them.
Because it's the brand, and it's a very powerful. And so that is what we will leave this on, is the problem with Steinway.
It's not marketing. It's subliminal permanence. They're in the subliminal mind of everyone. Because I say it again, people, isn't Steinway the best? Well, yeah, they're one of the best. But can you name me two or three other piano manufacturers that make just as good quality, if not better, pianos?
Yeah, it's very interesting. So please leave your thoughts. We'd love to hear you guys. We might be completely wrong on this.
Oh, we're going to get a lot of blowback.
We are willing to accept that. This is what our perception is, the problem with Steinways and vintage ones in particular.
Someone will throw down a challenge and say, let's see you two bozos rebuild a piano and see how it goes.
That would be an entertaining
video.
That
would be fun. That would take us years.
Well, thank you guys for watching. Ted Barcelo, I'm Patrick Marr with Alamo Music. You can find us online at alamomusic.com. Please subscribe if you want to see more great content. We love to bring you guys amazing stories, whatever happened to certain piano brands, all the way to why you need to know X, Y, or Z before purchasing a Steinway or a Kawai or a Yamaha or any other piano brand. We love doing these videos. Thank you guys for watching.